Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to another episode of Let's Build, your cure for the Mondayitis, at least that syndrome that you get every Monday when you go back to work. So I'm going to spend this time, as always in these episodes, just playing some music and doing some casual work in the background, and you guys can leave it running in the background if you want. At least that's what some people enjoy. But these are not full-blown tutorials, they're just very casual, I guess just random artworks kind of a deal. Okay, so I won't be doing any editing on this. Generally, I'll just leave this running in real time and we'll just sit, chat, and chill. Okay, now what you see here, we've got the UDK editor open, and these are the assets that are created in the previous episodes. You can see we've got some apples in crates. We've also got some wood construction wood pieces or planks just set up there, just to give this a little bit of a story, at least, well, we kind of know what this is all about. So this is a wooden dock and some little bits right here. So the past week, I've spent a bit more time creating new assets, and I'll just turn around just to show you guys right here. So we've got these little wooden platforms, or very large wooden platforms. We've got some arches, plants, fences as well, and of course a bunch of stairs. Alright, so far if I just press G to turn into game mode, you can see we've got some nice readable results. And these weren't very difficult to make either, they're fairly simple to do. The plants, unfortunately, I haven't had time to double check how to actually create, a procedural wind mapping on these plants, plant leaves yet. And as you probably already know in my previous episodes, I do not have extensive knowledge of UDK. I am still just playing around with this, but after about a few, maybe 3 weeks of using this, I am overall very pleased with the editor. This editor is very easy to use, very simple to get your head around. There are a few things that sort of bug me. They're very, very minor though, they're no big deal. But I highly recommend using this if you are, if you want to get into game creations, okay? But I did say before, I am not a programmer. I have not made games, made any games before, so I have no experience in that. But if I were to recommend one thing in terms of balance of license and ease of use and graphics, Unreal, the UDK, is probably the best out of a number of them that I've used. So just underneath this, you can see we've got some platforms and struts just holding this up. Okay. So very simple. I've spent, just a few days creating these assets. So sorry I haven't had time to create videos, I've had a few problems, but we're going to create new assets to fill in this scene right here. And namely, it's going to be the flag and create some cloth here. Okay, so depending on how we go, this might be a very short Let's Build series, episode. Alright, so I'm going to just close that out, and as always in these episodes, we start off with a music playlist, and today, courtesy of Blizzard, I'm going to play some StarCraft 2 soundtracks. Okay, so the link is below if you want to have a listen to that in a more extensive manner, but I'll leave this running in the background. So I do have to apologize, guys. I do have a bit of hay fever. This is hay fever season out in Australia. So it's not... I'm going to be sneezing and I might sound a little bit stuffy every now and then, okay? Alright, so far, very pleased with the results of our assets. Again, haven't spent too long on this. I still got to iron out a few bugs, namely some polygon skipping or noise here. We've got a bit of grain coming through. That's mainly because the faces are on the same plane as each other, so the computer's kind of struggling as to which one should be on the surface. It's very simple to fix. I'll have to fix that in the near future. But other than that, everything is quite tight, looking good so far. Alright, so to save a bit of processing time, I'm going to have to close this because this is actually slowing down my computer a lot. So it's just going to make it easier for me to work with Maya. And today what I'm going to do is create some flag struts that will come out of these arches right here. I hope it's not going to crash. And we'll also create some cloth simulation utilizing the physics engine. Alright, so first thing we want to do is go ahead and start conceptualizing the flag. And what I'm going to do is begin very simply with just a very simple brush, like so. Let me check, I'm on UDK, might have crashed actually. May or may not have, not too certain. I'm just going to assume it crashed, so we'll close this out and I guess we'll worry about it later. That's okay, we won't need it for what we're trying to do right now. Alright. So as always, whenever you're creating assets, you want to make sure you have some kind of concept. So just so that you're not building things blindly. Because if you do build things blindly, you run into a very high risk of creating an asset that doesn't look that great. And I've seen it happen far too many times. People started, you know, people get lazy and they don't spend time, you know, at least just drawing out some kind of image for what they want to make. And what happens? Well, it happens almost, I'd say 95% of the time, you create an asset and spend all this time making something, and then you get to the finish line and then it doesn't look that great. So that's one thing you want to avoid as much as you can. And that's the whole point of doing concept art. Okay, it just helps prevent that from happening. And concept art doesn't take too long either. I think it's closed out, which is great. It doesn't take too long, so you might as well. Alright, so this is going to be the flag. It might just be a nice long flag like so. Now remember, the theme that I'm trying to keep or maintain is an Italian Renaissance theme. And using a mental library in my head through, I guess, school or a variety of art, video games that I've played, I get an idea of what this flag is going to look like. Okay, so Italian, right now it's looking very medieval. So probably England, kind of a flag. If I did something like this, so this is very medieval, but the instant you do something like add a small little flourish right here, now suddenly it looks Italian, at least in my mind's eye anyway. Okay. So this is the reason why you want to do that. If you tried to model this in Maya, you are probably going to be fumbling around in the dark for a number of hours before you get something good. Whereas if you go into Photoshop, or even a pencil and a piece of paper, you just draw this out, problem solved. You're like, oh, okay, that looks very Italian, I like this. And yeah, you can go from there. So it's something that I stress as a huge importance when it comes to your work. Okay, it's also just good workflow as well. Most professional industries do this anyway. So for this flag, I guess to maintain the ornamental feel of it, might have something like... something like that. And maybe for this I might have, I don't know, a spindle icon. Maybe. So you can see, you don't have to texture it, you don't have to color it if you want. This is a very simple asset, I don't have to color it, I kind of already got an idea. You can if you want, so like in our case, maybe we might as well do it. So I'm just going to go ahead and use my brush, and it doesn't have to be tidy, just trying to get an idea of the theme. Like so. Pardon me. So already, you can see you get a very nice result. So this might be maybe gold plate, I'm not sure. This icon is just for reference, I'm not going to use it for the final thing. It's just to see what this looks like in practice, I guess. So we've got maybe a gold border, might have some ornaments as well, but in general this is kind of what we're going to go for. Oops, I think I've lost that there. Alright, so that's our flag. This is what we're going to do. We're going to go to Maya and we're going to start modeling this again. We're going to start with this little strut and then we'll go from there. So creating a concept, now you have an idea of what you want to do, you want to create, you can just go, oh bang, I'm just going to get straight into it. And what was I doing? That's right, I was creating the model. Losing track of what I have. Alright, Let's start with my height reference. This is a macro that I created for myself. It's just a custom macro, and all it does is just tells me how high a character will be in UDK, just so that I stay consistent with my scaling. So this is another macro I created, and it's just a very simple cube that I've mapped out myself. Just helps with saving me a little bit of time creating the little assets. But what I'm doing is creating the long strut right here. So we start off with a very long strut. Pardon me. And you can do this a number of ways. I'm just looking at this and thinking, how do I want to tackle this? I think I might want to turn this on a slight angle. So maybe let's go minus 45 degrees. I'm going to center the pivot. Okay. So that's what we've got right now. Let's go ahead and insert some edge loops so that we can create this particular, I guess, the spike on the end. Okay. Very, very simple. I guess my rotation is a bit messed up. Actually, no, I'll leave that as it is. Let's just go ahead and freeze the transformations. Great. And merge vertices. Let's go ahead and merge that on the end there. Alright, so we've got a nice spear-like, I guess, end bit. Doesn't necessarily have to do it this way, but I'm just going roughly to plan with the, I guess, the concept that I drew. So nice. I like to keep it nice and simple. There's also a tab. Oops, I should save this. Where should I save it? I'll save it under the cloth decor. Now I've created a flag previously, so I want to actually. I'm gonna, just in interest of staying, I guess, true to this episode. Oh no, it's already empty, so that's great. That previous flag was more of a test, so this is kind of the second time I've created this flag. And if you're wondering what theme that I'm trying to go for, these are the mouse characters that will be inhabiting that level that you saw just now, okay? So, trying to keep true to that Italian Renaissance theme. It's not going to look like Assassin's Creed, but like I did mention before, I am a fan of Assassin's Creed, but that's not what I'm aiming for here. Alright. Okay, so we're creating the extra tab just in the back face right there. Again, it helps break up the seams of the entire mesh. Let's soften the edges, and then I'll harden the edges once more just to double check. I think I'll leave it like that for now. So that's a little rim. Now we're going to get to the fairly tricky aspect, which is this very strange curve here. So there are a number of ways you can tackle this. One, you can go ahead and use a CV curve tool. And I'm just going to go ahead. Just draw some curves. It's better to use curves, guys, so you get a more accurate result. I'm gonna go ahead and just make it a little bit smaller like that. Pardon me. So I'm gonna go ahead and just shrink some of these and adjust them until I get a nice elaborate curve. So I must say, StarCraft 2, definitely a very, very high quality video game. I certainly enjoy it. Among my favorites, such as Assassin's Creed. It's less about the gameplay. Whenever I play games, it's less about the gameplay for me and more about the so-called art aspect of it. and I have a deep appreciation of video game art. And I would say Assassin's Creed is one of my biggest inspirations. Same with Crysis and such, those games like that. Very, 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 very nice. Okay, so once we've got that down, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a small... I have to use an EP curve tool for this, because it's going to be a bit tricky. And what I'm going to do is create a diamond shape. Center the pivot. Now, I haven't used this particular tool for a while, but what you can do is now you can lock this onto the curve and have it loft around creating your surface, okay? Now, any other 3D software can probably do this in a quicker fashion, but Maya, you got to do it quite manually, so I think it's create animated sweep. No, it's not. First, I have to lock it on. Motion pass. So let's go time slider 24. So 24 frames. I want 20. I want to make maybe. Let's make 20 frames. Or 20 divisions, okay? So I'm doing it based on the slider. Front axis is Y. Up axis is X. Perfect. And I hope this is the correct way of doing it. So, what's happened now is it's gone ahead and now it creates all those little divisions right there. Alright. So now I can go to animate and create animated sweep. So I'll use time slider again and just create a polygon, surface degree, Q linear, chord length. Okay, so I don't want uniform, I want chord length. Chord length makes basically evens out the divisions along the entire axis. Okay, that's very messy. So what's happened is halfway through it actually spins out. So let's try... Yep, computer's confusing itself, so it's struggling a little. Let's try uniform and see what we get. No, we don't get anything better than that. Go back and try this again. So this time I'll shrink it down, freeze the transformations, and let's do that. So this is a bit tricky. Attach to motion path. Okay, let's see if this works. Hopefully it will work. Where are we gonna go? Let's try that. We'll get a slightly better result. But it is having a few problems, so what I'm gonna try and do is just create an animated snapshot, and I might do it manually. Okay, so the animated snapshot basically creates 24 of these based on, or 20 based on the number I've set. And now what I can do is go ahead and manually just go center the pivot. Oh, I might just select them all. Center the pivot for them all. So whatever your 3D application you were using, you can go ahead and just create your own workflow, okay? Again, this is based on your own experiences. You'll have to make those decisions yourself. Alright, so with this, let's go ahead and select them in order. And what I'm going to do is use a loft tool. Hopefully this will help me adjust those problem areas that we were encountering previously. Alright, so with that, let's go to surface. I think it's surfaces, loft. Keep it as subdivisions, keep it as quads, and let's see what we get. Okay, it's not working. it's inverting in this particular direction. So what I'll do is I'm going to just do that. So the snapshot group is, let's see if this helps. Yeah, it does. It does help. So I'll put it back to 1.09. Great. So we've fixed that problem. Now we're still getting problems here. Let's go ahead and fix that. So like I said, there have been issues with these very, very simple tools. Ideally, you don't want to use Maya to create your motion graphics because it is a little bit slow, but because I'm only just modeling, I don't really care. At least you guys can see how I'm solving problems that I'm encountering in Maya. Okay, so now we've got a much nicer look here. So we've still got some problems here. Let's go ahead and fix that. Hide this cover. So yeah, just learning how to solve problems like this will help you get better overall. It's a little very strange looking curve right there. I'm gonna make it so I don't have to select that. But I'm actually quite pleased with how this is turning out. It's looking quite nice. I do want it to be a little bit thicker in some respects. So you can make these very tiny adjustments, looking at the way you want it to look. Now I realize there are a lot of polygons here, which I am okay with for now. Trying to get a nice silhouette based on that. I've kind of gone off a bit of a tangent in terms of the design. That's totally fine. There we go. So these little flourishes will be very useful to use in a later project. So you don't have to delete them, you can reuse them later. It's kind of what you want to do. You want to be super efficient when it comes to this. Okay, looking really nice so far. So I'm just making these tiny adjustments, and you might be thinking to yourself, oh man, you should be going a little bit faster than this. That's one thing that I have been debating with myself for quite some time. Is it better to go really fast and get a substandard result, or should you take your time and just go real slow to make sure you get everything right the first time around? And I've done both. I tend to be very impatient when it comes to work, especially when it comes to modeling things like this. And through my experiences, I would have to say slowing down is better than going real quick. So getting a nice result, basically I think the motto was do it right the first time and only the first time, so you don't have to think about it later. I can't remember. I think it was something like, do it once, do it right. And that motto, through my personal experiments, is very true. So if you are an artist who likes to rush, as in you like to do this, you like to click real fast, get everything done as well as, you're basically on coffee constantly. You might save, probably half an hour in a 2-hour job. Half an hour. But you'd realize at the end of the line, the result doesn't look that great. So, again, I have done both, and I think I feel qualified to say this. It's much better for you to just go nice and slow. Just look at it like this and go, okay, I like the silhouette. This one thing's bugging me right now, but I want to take some time, in the next 5 minutes, to fix it and make sure I get it right. And the long-term wise, that's a much better... I think that's a much better way of working. But that's, again, this is just in my opinion. I can't really say for sure. I can't speak for everybody, because everyone does have a certain way of working. But overall, I think going nice and slow just gets you a better result in the long run anyway. So what I'm doing right now is just adjusting these little tiny problems. I'm quite happy with this so far. It's turned out a lot better than I thought. So there are other tools that you can use to get results like this much quicker. By all means, do it. If you can get a better result using other tools, do it. You don't have to use Maya, you can use Blender. I think Cinema 4D has better tools overall. But I think that it's more catered to motion graphics as far as I can tell. I could be wrong. But motion graphics is definitely its strongest point. I think because of its speed and its integration with After Effects as well. So if motion graphics is something that you fancy, then definitely check out some of Cine 4D's, motion graphics capabilities. Alright, with that done, go ahead, duplicate, and let's move this out of the group, or the snapshot group right here. So we're going to resize that down there in just a moment, but I'm going to go ahead and put it all in another layer so I can hide them all. So this is the completed ornament, I guess. I know it's very high poly, I'm going to try and reduce that. And of course the flag is very simple, it's just a big polygon, just a flat polygon. Little thing right here. Because it is down that direction, I'm going to try and even it out so that we have just a number of squares, and I think that should be sufficient, division wise. Maybe we can go down to 8. Yep, I think it's quite reasonable. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and... I might make this 9, actually. Just implement that top thing there. Alright, great. So our flag is looking really nice so far. I just want to adjust this here. Now, in terms of reducing poly count on this particular asset right here, I want to see if I can use... This may or may not work, guys. Again, Maya is not as, flexible when it comes to creating a lot of your assets. But I'm just working with this. But it might help you guys, because you get to see how I work the long way. Where is... Reduce polygons. My brain is not working today. I have used it before. I don't remember where it was. I think one thing people are wondering when it comes to tutorials is, why do I teach the long way? Why do I go the long way instead of showing everyone the shortcuts in general? Well, that's not true. I do show shortcuts every now and then. The reason why I teach the long way, and the reason why most teachers teach the long way, the long tedious way, is because you need to understand the principles behind it, okay? Because when it comes to speeding up your workflow and working really quickly, you can come up with those yourself. as you learn through experience. Sorry guys, I'm just trying to find where that went. It's very frustrating. I don't know why. Reduce polygons. I might have kind of avoided it. But yeah, the reason why we go the long ways so that you can learn the principles, and as you gain an experience, once you know the long way principles, you'll be able to use your brain to create mental shortcuts for yourself, and then you'll be able to make your own shortcuts. So it's very important that you learn things the long way first, otherwise it's very difficult for you to get faster in your work. Because if we teach you the shortcuts, then you probably won't understand the reason why we did what we did. Oh dear me, for the life of me, I cannot remember where that is. Reduce polygons, it has to be somewhere. It has to be somewhere here. I apologize guys, I will find this. Reduce polygons, come on. Okay, I can't remember. I cannot for the life of me remember where that is, so I'm gonna go to my... Oops, web. Polyreduce. Where is it? Well, these are just some of the problems you might encounter. Even veterans, sometimes you might forget. They might just completely forget where they're at. They're like, where is that tool I used, like, once in my lifetime? Cannot remember where it is. The other annoying thing is Maya tends to, I think, change the names of it every now and then. I think I know a few tools have changed names in between 2009 and 2012. So it has been very frustrating. For example, the poly split tool has turned into something else. So it took us a while to try and figure it out. And to be honest, I don't know why they do that. It does get very frustrating. So poly reduce. But in any case, I'm gonna, while that thing's searching, because it is very slow, I'm just going to lock these off. Let's go to my outliner and create a group. I'm gonna create a group for this as well, so we'll call this the build group. And this group is going to be the flag group. Okay, so drop flag 01, and I'm just gonna put an A on the end. Let's go up here and... Alright, so in UDK, if you wanted to create a cloth, you need to create a joint. So what I'm going to do is go and create skin... Oh, sorry, joint tool. Let's create one joint on the top up here. I know it's very hard to see. Let's create one more joint down here, and then I'll create a last joint down the bottom. So these are joints of three. Let's just turn it to larger, so I'll put it 12. Okay, I'm not worried about the last one, so this is how it's going to work. I'm going to hold D and just move that bone down there. Alright, so what we do, pardon me, I'll leave those bones there for now, but the joint number 2, I'll just call it cloth. Cloth flag. That's the name of the joint. Just keep that in the back of your head. Poly reduce. Mesh reduce. I see. So mesh. Reduce. Okay, that's very bizarre. Let's go 25% and see what we can. So it gets messed up a little bit. There we go. Much tidier. Somewhat. Let's go 40%. Oh dear, we might have to do this manually then. It's very frustrating. Alright, well, I spent all of that time trying to figure out how to fix that, so that was very, very annoying. Okay, so we can do this manually, it's not too difficult. We'll just go ahead and select those flat faces that we don't need. Yep, just make those deletions there. Same with this. So just double click and there we go. Much nicer. Alright, great. Select those vertices. Oops. Select those vertices and delete. So we delete those stray vertices. On the ends here, I'm going to go ahead and go merge the vertices tool, like so. Great, so we've got a nice pointed end. Same with this one. Merge vertex tool. Great. Got some more stray edges. Let's go ahead and delete them. And let's take our time and double check to make sure all those stray vertices are gone. Once they're gone, we can go ahead and delete that. Alright, and I did mention before, we have to do this manually, so what I'm going to do is, just in the back of my head, I'll have to do this by eye. So I'll probably get rid of every second edge. And yes, I do realize this is very tedious, guys. Like I said, if you find a faster way of doing this, maybe in another of your, 3D app, do it. Don't do it the way I did it. Just that I haven't spent a lot of time creating this kind of topology before, so I was a bit stumped as to how I was going to tackle this. But thankfully I wasn't too bad. So this is a bit very, very tedious, but at least I can get good control over. Decent control over my topology. Alright, so one more time. Let's get rid of some of these vertices. Down here, I think we've got a nice straight liner, which I don't think we need that many polygons on, so we'll get rid of those as well. There we go. It's maintained a relatively readable shape so far. Hope you guys are enjoying this music. I am a bit of a fan of StarCraft 2, as I did mention. But the one thing I really can appreciate is certainly the soundtrack. It's very impressive, very, very impressive. Great, so that's our low polygon asset. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to harden the edges just on the center point right there, so that we get a nice readable surface. Okay, so the hard edges just on the outside there. But other than that, it's looking real nice. Alright, I think we're done with this, so let's go ahead and start UV mapping this. Mapping this out. So I've got my UV texture editor. Let's unfold that so we get a nice proportion of that flag right there. So a flag is very simple, and these two will be relatively easy as well. So I'm going to go planar mapping, same with this one as well. Alright, and what I'm going to do is select the edges and make it a half-half. So just reusing a lot of the assets as best as we can. Oops, let's go ahead and select that and just unfold. There we go. So we've got a nice proportion of that spearhead, I guess. So put it over there. Just sorting out all of these little problems. Okay, and for this one, very simple again. I'm going to cut it all the way on the halfway point. So shrink this down. Check to see what I've got. Okay, so I've got the front. I'm gonna go for the back. The back shell. So let's see if we can unfold this and get something a little bit better. No, I'm actually happy with how it looks right now, okay? And it just makes it easier for us to, I guess, maintain the integrity or the distortions there. And it makes sense for the texture artist as well. So it doesn't, you don't have to be 100% perfect in that respect. Now, to make use of as much of this UV space as possible, I'm going to manually adjust the sizes of these assets. So I'm gonna go ahead and just move these shells, just adjust them and see what we can get. Might shrink that ever so slightly because it's not too big anyway. I think we're pretty good. So quite pleased with this. I'm just thinking atop my head, should I add a little bit more, but I think I'm happy with this already. So that's the UV map for our entire object. Before I do that, before I send this out, let's do one last thing. Okay, we're gonna tidy up all of these meshes. Just about done. I think we're hitting the 1 hour mark where we should be. Oh no, we're only half an hour through. Okay, great. Alright, let's duplicate. Well, I'll add this to another layer first, so we'll call this working layer. I like to keep these working layers there. Alright, so with that, let's let the objects duplicate and combine. Okay, so now we only have one object. Okay, so this is all combined together. Let me rename this and call this flag. And with that, let's go ahead and skin. And remember, I'm doing this because I want this flag to wave in the wind. And UDK requires you to create these joints like so. Now the joints here, they're not perfectly, you know, skin bound. We have to adjust the skin. So let's go to my paint skin weights tool. And I'm going to go interactive. And let's replace one with everything, so that means the other joints have nothing. Okay, so I'm going to lock that joint, I'll leave that one on, and I'm going to go to joint one and paint in white everything else on the first joint. Okay, just like so. Very, very simple. So I'm going to paint only the just the top aspect here, plus the top of that flag, because it is attached to the metal bit there. So what you get is the second one down here, only the bottom part of that flag will be waving, whereas this top one will hold the rest. Okay, so that's pretty much it. Oops. So what I'm gonna do is rename that so that we have just the selected files. Alright, so I'm gonna go export selection. Hopefully this will work. I have had some problems every now and then. And in the back of my head, I'm trying to remember if I needed to enable any of those bones. Bone pose. Okay. Let me save this out as 1A, just as a working file. Let's go back to 1. And let's delete everything else. Oops. Unbelievable. History, so we maintain the skin bind. There we go. Must have had a connection still linked to that. All right. So now that we've only got that, Oops. Sorry, guys. I'm just tidying up my scene. Okay, my apologies. Let's try this again. So I'm going to export all. Maybe this might not work. No, it's not going to work. Unbelievable. I cannot remember for the life of me what I needed to... Nope, triangulate. Definitely need that on. Leave constraints on as well. Use the DAG node current transform. Oh, please tell me I don't need to figure this out online. Alright, well, let's give this a try in UDK. And then we're gonna go ahead and paint the texture on top. Okay, so we've got maybe another 20-ish minutes or so. This might take a little bit longer than it should, so... But that's okay. Let's go ahead and go to... Cloth Decor. And hopefully this will... No, it doesn't work. Oops, pardon me. So again, I do apologize, guys, if you're watching the struggle with some of these assets, but like I said before, I am still trying to get my head around this. And so I'm not going to be too accurate in that respect. Alright, what I'm going to do, just while I leave that there for now and try and figure this out a little bit later, I'm going to go ahead and paint the flag, I guess what we call the flag, folds. I'm going to spend a bit of time just quickly doing this, because I want the flag to have some kind of fold definition. Don't want it to be too flat, so to speak. So what I'm doing is very... Actually, that's probably horrible job that I've done there. Let's try this again. So let's go and... Accent Mudbox. Send us a new scene. Come on. And I'm only focusing on... I don't really care about the top there. I'm just focusing on the flag itself, the cloth of it. So I'm going to divide it maybe 3 times. Which is great. Maybe 4 times. And all I'm really doing right now is creating a normal map, okay? So let's go ahead and... Let's double check our brush, make sure it's nice and great. So I'm gonna just reduce it. Very, very subtle cloth folds. It's very subtle. You can barely see it. This will add a lot of realism to your flag, especially when it comes to us creating normal maps. And the reason why I'm using Mudbox is because this is more accurate to do. I'm just creating these folds as the deformation sort of folds down, like so. You don't want to make it too weird. Something like that. We can export this normal map out just to simulate some realistic falls. Alright, I'm reasonably happy with that. I'm not going to spend too much time creating that. So let's go to extract texture maps. And I'm going to grab a normal map from this. So resolution at 0. And I'm going to go subdivision. Let's make this a 2K texture. Anti-aliasing, maybe we'll leave it off, because we don't really need that. And let's save this under the cloth decor. So normal temp. This will take a while, I think it depends on how fat the computer is. Of course it does, but we'll see what we can get. Alright, so then the final problem I have, I guess, is this particular one. Maybe if I lose the... Export all. That should be right as far as I can tell. So getting it out of the group might help get a good result, but thankfully, maybe not. Oh dear, tell me why. Tell me why it won't work. Tell me, please. I promise I'll be good. Should have solved the problem. Seems like it was one of those strange grouping things, but I've at least taken a mental note of that. At least now I won't have to worry about that. So sorry about that, guys. That has been a bit strange. Alright, so we've got our normal map ready. What am I looking at? We have another 10-ish minutes to go. Hopefully we can get this done by then. Actually, I think we will. So with the object successfully imported into UDK. Let's go ahead and create the texture node. So I'm just going to create a diffuse file. Bump mapping file. Definitely we need the bump mapping file and of course the specular file. Alright, let's go ahead to Photoshop. Just temporarily put it there for now. First we need to export the UV map. So let's go UV snapshot, select it out. Put it into the decor flag right here, and we're ready to start texturing. You can texture in Mudbox if you want. It's up to you. Like I said, whatever works best for you, whatever's fastest for you, use it. The base is not supposed to be. It's supposed to be gray. Diffuse shouldn't be like that. Alright, so with this, we can now create our flag. First I'm going to put the metal, those metal aspects there first. So we'll go to my texture, metal, and bare metal, very very simple. Although I might want to use this one because it does have a nice texture to it. Maybe this one as well. It just looks a little bit better because there's some inconsistencies with the actual texture rather than flat. Rasterize and delete. Now, very important, your diffuse of your metal should be relatively dark. Okay? This is because metal is more from specularity and reflectivity rather than diffuse. So you just want to use something like that. That's kind of what I'm going for anyway. Change the colors a little bit, just to give it a bit of a warmer feel. Something like that. Alright. So this is going to be the specularity for the metal, so I just call it spec. And specularity should be very bright. But also needs to be fairly contrasty. We're not using this layer for... That's going to be the diffuse. This will be the specularity. We're just putting it aside for now. In terms of... I think in terms of normal mapping, we might go ahead and do that. So let's go ahead, open up Endo 2. Endo 2, fastest way to create very quick normals in Photoshop. You don't want to use it to create, I think, everything, but most things, it's very useful, okay? Let's go something very simple. Let's go just ceramic roof. It's so subtle, you won't really notice, but I'm using a ceramic roof because it's quickest to process. Very, very harsh. That's fine. We will definitely fix this. So ceramic details, I might just go smooth base as less. And we'll stick with the ceramic details. So you can use a preview just to double check. Great. So that done. Let's export the normal. So, bring this in. Now we have, remember the mudbox normal we were doing with the flag? We're going to bring that in as well. As you gain in experience, you'll be able to make these mental notes automatically. You won't need people to tell you what to do. Well, I'll just bring this whole thing in so that we maintain it. So that's the normal that we painted in Mudbox, and then we combined it with the normal we generated using Endo 2, okay? So it looks really, really good so far. Alright, now in terms of flag texture, let's go and get some fabric, just a fabric overlay, and then I guess we'll start, actually no, let's begin. I'll start by sort of roughly making it the same as, I guess the same as the image here. So I might make it make this a bit of a reddish flag, maybe brownish flag. Okay. And what I'm going to do is go and just create this little tab down the bottom. And remember, we will have transparencies, so don't worry. No need to fret. So that's going to be the transparency on the bottom, I'm just leaving that base there. Let's go and find some... Oops, pardon me. Alright, so in this layer, I'm going to use a grey color again. A nice solid brush. I'm just gonna very roughly draw some ornamental things here. Ideally, you probably want to use something like Illustrator to get nice, accurate curves. Unfortunately, I'm not up to that task just yet. But I am gonna create the border. Oops, not duplicate, let's rasterize. Okay. Ah, dear me. Pressing the wrong buttons here and there. Alright, and let's go ahead and use the... shape tool or the line tool and create the bottom section of that. Oh dear me. I have to do this manually then. All Alright, let's go ahead and delete that line. That unwanted line. Great. Okay, so we've got a nice border. I'm going to duplicate this. Actually, I might just shrink that a little bit. Great. Now we can create some very simple ornaments. Or you can go ahead and use ornaments in CG textures. So I'm going to try, maybe use something like that. That could be very useful, as I would say. Okay, very, very difficult to get or extract. So I might have to. Yeah, this is going to be very difficult to extract. See if we can find something else, just as an example. Again, not trying to be too anal about this. I'm just trying to get something done. That one might be easier to get. So I want to get some, I guess, flourishes for my. Well, actually, that one might be perfect. Might not have to do anything after all. Alright, so let's go ahead and just plant that. Side. So what I'm after is just the plant right here. Maybe the outskirts of that as well. So let's go ahead and grab this. Invert, delete. So our flag will be, I guess, relatively good. Relatively. I guess time will tell. Alright, I think that's good enough for at least what we want to do. This is not complete, by the way, it's not complete in any way, guys, so that's okay. But I do want to move on. I've spent enough time trying to I've been dragging this out a little bit too long. So let's save out the whatever that is, the diffuse. I will also export the norm maps. Again, using the same naming convention. Oops. And let's go to UDK very quickly. Actually, no, let's just fix the textures up so that we can export this out properly. So with the files, let's go to get our diffuse map, get our specular map. Oh, that's the wrong area. So our diffuse. I'll use the same diffuse for the specular map as well, just for now. And also, of course, we've got our normal map right there. And yes, we don't have the. But you can see the normal map's looking real nice. Okay. Very quick. We don't have the alpha yet. That's fine. But I'm going to go show you guys how to very quickly create the wind. So I'm going to re-import that flag that I just got rid of. Oops, that's wrong. I did not save that out. Transport ore. And let's go back to import. This will import our current materials. I will have to re-import this later. But for now, I think it'll be good just to demonstrate how the UDK cloth is very simple to use. Oh dear, don't tell me you've crashed. That would be not nice. Or that would not be nice at all. Very impressive range of music, I have to say. Alright, so with the flag down here, I'm going to open up my level demo. So we can bring the flag in. You can see we've got our flag. It's not moving, it's not animated. There's no physics happening. Plus, we only have one face on the flag, so we're going to have to fix that. Simple fix, just go to your materials, make sure you have two-sided on. Okay. And save it out, yes. Takes a while for it to redo. Okay, so we've got two-sided, but at the moment it's not moving, okay? It's not animated or it's not using any of the wind physics. So what you want to do is go to your skeletal mesh. And in here, you've got the cloth segment. So this is the preview, which you can use to double-check your image. So let's go to enable... Oh, wait, where is it? Force CPU skinning. And you get to select the cloth bones. So we're going to select the cloth bones and we're going to call it a cloth flag. Okay, so this is the bone right here that will be making it animate. And with that done, you can just toggle cloth on and now you have animated cloth. Okay. Okay, this is very strange. Trying to navigate around here. So it looks really, really nice so far. Great. So for us to see this in our scene, we're going to have to go to... Just making... Oh, where is it? Physics. Unbelievable. I cannot remember this for the life of me. I'm sorry guys, I am still trying to get my head around this. I have said this many times. Come on. There we go. Alright, that should theoretically work. So let's go press F8 and check this out in our scene. Where are you? There we go. Okay, it is animated, but we have to change some of the settings because the wind just isn't. It's not giving me anything. So for the cloth wind, let's go Y. Give it one in one direction, give it a bit of Z direction, and some of it in X direction. So for you to get good results, you'll have to check it yourself and see what you can get. Yep. So it is moving. It's not looking that great though. I can't remember. X would be the... Let's just fix up some cloth for scale and post scale. Not too certain about that. Don't know what some of these are, so I'll leave them for now. There we go. It's looking nice now. Okay. So let's go ahead and rotate this 180 degrees, and we can just plug him up over the top there. And I think we're coming to the end of our episode of Let's Build, guys. Larger. There we go. So that's our flags so far. So you get an idea of what Silverwood is like. Well, at least that's what the city of the name, that's the working name for the city. But our cloth flags are looking quite nice so far. Okay. Alright, with the time that we have left, I'm going to quickly fix up the alpha maps, or the alpha channels on the textures right here. And there is a technique to do this properly. I'm certain we have already reached the end of it. I'm just gonna play a few more minutes of this. Let's close this up. Also close this up because we don't need that anymore. Great. Now what I'm going to do is just merge those posts together so that we get this. And what this is going to be is going to be the alpha. And what it's going to be is just simply white. And then, oops, and then black. Let's merge those posts together. So this will be the alpha. And all you really have to do is just copy, select it all, copy, go to channels, create a new channel, and it will automatically create an alpha channel right here. And just paste that in. Now what you get, essentially, is you've got this with the alpha channel. So we can save this out. It's a PNG. This will have the alpha channel as well. Might also have to create the specular map too. So this is going to be the specular map. Let's save this out as well. So yes, very, very happy with how this turned out. Actually, very surprised with how it turned out. I wasn't expecting it to turn out the way it did. But I guess it did, so, which is very pleasing. One other thing I forgot to do is make sure you save the defuse so that we don't get any halo effects when it comes to the alpha channel there. So you can create your alpha channel anyway. You can make those little tiny cloth bits if you want to be really elaborate. I don't have time to do it right now. I'm just trying to keep this real simple, and we'll do that next time. It's very rare that I can keep this under 1 hour, because making your assets is pretty time consuming overall. So with the specular map, let's select the specular map right there. So we get a nice, just a much nicer, vibrant specularity. With this as well, it's going to be just that. Alright. I know the alpha channel is not there yet, but we're going to fix that in UDK. So let's export this out. Done. I'm going to delete the flag again, because I'm still trying to figure out how to refresh, I think, all the textures all at once. Although I know how to refresh the objects, I'm just not certain how to refresh the actual textures. So if anyone can tell me how to do that, that'd be great. It will just save me a little bit of time re-importing and redoing all the settings. It's going to take a while for it to import. There have been changes to the textures. One of the great things about, I think, going nice and slow when you're working on your assets is that you don't have to come back to them ever again. And I think a lot of people, I think they tend to just, you know, underestimate how important that is. If you have to come back to it over and over again, you lose a lot of motivation. It actually gets very frustrating to use. So to make, you know, being real thorough in your workflow will help you just avoid those problems. So let's double check, make sure, yep, so we've got a good flag. Movement. It's looking great. Now the material, I'm going to bring this in. Just want to show you guys very quickly. Now let me fix up the double-sided. Two-sided there. So you can see there's no alpha channel on the bottom. Alright, so for us to do this, we have to go to our material. Now remember that alpha channel in our defuse, or in our PNG. We're going to grab that channel and put it under... just put it under the transparency mask, okay? Now, because the... what is it? Opacity mask is missing, or opacity is missing, you have to change the blend mode to masked. Okay, so with this, remember, this is the diffuse. You have all colors, RGB, red, green, blue, alpha. We're going to drag the alpha and put it under opacity mask. Come on. There we go. And now you can see it's very hard to see. I can't really see it there. But that should give you the alpha channel in your object or in your asset right here. At least it's supposed to. Theoretically. Come on, why are you not working? Alright, until I figure out how to do this, I think I might put an end to this. This is just making me angry. So we'll finish this up. I'll have to go and fix this up in a future... a little bit later. Oh, UDK, why are you so unpredictable? Sorry, I can't blame UDK. I am the one using this, so... I have to work with the program, not against it. Okay, guys. Hope you have enjoyed this... very long-winded tutorial. Sorry, this episode of Let's Build. Hope you've enjoyed the music as well. We'll come back shortly with more at some point. Well, more videos will come later. Very, very soon. Alrighty. So if you like this content, please subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Hopefully with a better looking flag than this.